Well, good day to you, my dear friends. It's time to solve some LeetCode problems. Yay! Well, actually, it's not the best time to solve LeetCode problems. Still, I have a very busy schedule. Unfortunately, I just can't find enough time. But this is temporary. I just have some real world issues, you know. And also, all of a sudden, I have a few job interviews ahead of me in the next couple of days, and I have to prepare. So, I'm very busy, but we have to solve some LeetCode problems. Let's do this right now. Just solve something without our regular routine, you know, explaining some previous problems. No. Right now we gonna solve something, maybe even something medium, but of course the easiest of the medium ones. We tried this, it was awful, it's JavaScript. This is a Ruby problem, let's try this one. Okay. Okay. What a strange output. So. Oh yeah. Why is it one? Okay, let's say so when we are here, Oh, this is the answer. So it's 3-2-1, we want to turn it into 1-2-3. It's like 2-1, you want to turn it into 1-2. Okay. Also, we want to have raw 0. Let's have an array numbers, nums, it's better, nums. Okay, so we start here and we want to collect the values like 3, 2, and 1. And we want to increment our row, and we want to increment our column, so that we move in this direction until we cannot move anymore. And we have nums. Now we want to sort nums. Yeah. And we're gonna do. The same thing again. It's called X for now. No, I do not want X, I want each with index. Let's call it sorted number. And the index we're gonna call X. And map raw X gonna be equal to s number, and we increment our row. And doing this, we gonna change everything that starts from the first row. After this, we want to take the first element in all the other rows and do the same thing. Let's check what we have. And we want to clean our numbers, of course. But we do clean our numbers, of course. Zero, zero is s num. Oh, I forgot to sort them. I lost my sorting somewhere along the way. This is strange. Let's have this array res. Also want to add sorted nums to result. Let's check what do we have here. We should have 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1. Nothing like this. Nah, it can't be the case. One, two, three, but it is 3, 3, 3. How can it be? Okay. But it's not gonna help. Oh. Oh, it's not num. Crazy bastard. It's this. Of course. It's obvious. Bloody hell. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1. Great. Now it's good. Good. X is index. Oh, we have double sort here. Not sure what is the consequences of having a double sort. Oh yeah. We do not want to do this with index. Just like this, in our index, well, it's gonna be, well, I for starters, but we of course want to, oh come on, increment it. Cool. Now, let's call it Y. Okay, let's call it raw. And let's call it raw index. And what I want to do is to avoid too much repetitions. Okay. Zombie killer whale. It's like you never sleep. It doesn't matter like what time I am online, you are always here. It's a wonder. Because you are a whale. Do you know how whales sleep? How they sleep? They one half of their brain sleeps while other half of their brain is active, so they're never fully asleep. La, 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 la. Well, let's do it the simplest way. I don't care about repetitions. We can always move everything to the separate method, you know, if we want. Now, mat. Let's say row is one, while mat row. We're gonna do. Oh, the same thing. Ba-da-da-da. Gonna do the same thing. But again, we want these variables. I hate it. Like another row, let's call it. Let's call it y. Y. Let's call it like this. So y. Y is equal to row. You know? And x is 0. Bum, 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 bum. And we want to do this again. Now, and x is 0 again, as num y x, and in the end we want to plus 1 our row. And that's it. Oi. Now you want to return our matrix. John matrix. Come on. Oh yeah. We want to have nums again. I become so nums. It's green and it is solved. Easy money. Okay, it's exactly the same code. Oh. What do we want to give this method? Met raw and x. Yeah, it's exactly the same, right? Right. This is y, this is x. Boom, 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 boom. Of course it's the same. Take it and we move it here. So it's going to be mat, it's going to be. Zero is gonna be I. This is Okay. Okay. Of course, I should have tested, but I never do that. I'm above testing. Aha. Raw, and we want to send what? We start from. Oh, I forgot where we start. We start from zero. Right from the start, you were a thief, you stole my heart. Let's check. Of course. Why and. Oh, okay, it's an extra bracket. There is no such thing as extra bracket. Well, there is. Oi. So X is X. X is X. Oof. Ew. This is bad. Okay, let's call it I. Let's call it I. Here we do not even need raw. Like this. Good. Maybe. Now let's check. And call. It's not call anymore, it's X. Come on. Colonel X. Row is 1. We send 1. Oh. Of course not row. It's Y. Y. And here it's also Y. And it's all green, like Brian Austin green. Terrific. I don't know if I have time to solve something else. Kinda want, but I'm not sure. Let's see what awaits us in the future. Event emitter. You know, when you see a problem that is called like that, you just do not want to open it. Event emitter, probably some JavaScript problem. All possible full binary trees. Only a full would open such a problem. Nested array generator. Ah, they all bad. Let's solve something easy. You know, we already. Or maybe let's solve something hard. Huh? What if? Let's try the easiest of the hard problems. It's probably easier than, you know, a medium problem. Like medium rare, let's call it. Da-da-da. Recover a tree from pre-order traversal. Okay, I already forgot what pre-order means. It's like going to the left, then node, then to the right. Something like this. Oof. Jesus H. Christ. I tried something here, but it was like half a year ago. I didn't know anything about trees back then. So, our hard problem. We run a pre-order depth first search on the root of a binary tree. Look at this input. And we want to return this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Traversal character each do. Let's say we have a string, an empty string, and let's do this with index. So we're gonna have a character, we're gonna have an index, and if our character is equal to let's call it depth. I need another examples. So depth is 0. If char is dash, we're gonna do something. But I'm not gonna tell you yet. Let's do the else condition, because we start from this. We want to add our character to our string. Then we hit this dash. You know, when we hit this dash, also if we hit the character, if our depth is more than 0, we're gonna set depth to 0. Or we can even do this without checking anything. Depth is 0. Oh, no, 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 no. No, no. Let's not jump to conclusions. So when we hit a dash, we want to increment our depth. But also, hitting dash means that we don't have this number anymore, that it is ended. And we want to have another hash or an array, not even sure. Depth, it's gonna be like this, and then we're gonna do hash depth add our string. And after that, we want to refresh, to reset our string, and we want to set depth so. We want, of course, to increment our depth, but also it's like we want to set it to zero before that. Okay, if s I plus 1 is equal to dash, to do all that. Yeah, everything. Everything. And then we want to set depth to zero again. To start counting again here. Something like this. In the end, we're gonna have a hash of depth, you know? No. But why? Let's check our keys. Do we have anything in our hash? No. So we have a problem here somewhere. It's not S, you bloody fool. It's a traversal. Oh. Oh. It's a traversal. Better. Now what? One, two, five, three, four, six, and we lost seven somewhere. Oh. We want to have our seven. Now let's create a node. It's not that simple. But it's a binary tree. Now let's do depth is equal to 0. I don't know yet what I am going to do. Now for sure I want to create a tree node. It goes without saying. Set node is equal tree node new. Maybe it makes sense to go from the deepest level. gonna need a recursion here of some kind. Look at this monstrosity. How? One and then four. Two, three, four, here. One, two, three, and four. Nah. Let me comment all of this out. Oh no, come on, this is how it's done. Now first we have like a left, then we have a right. A node has only one child. That child is guaranteed to be the left child. It's not hard. It's not hard. Easy. One, it has two, it has five, two has three and four. Okay, I think I understand. Probably we do not need a hash for this. Here, when we add everything to the hash, we're gonna create a new node. What's it gonna be? Well, it's gonna be our s, but an integer. And we want to have a previous depth. If we do not have a previous depth, then it becomes zero. No. And now we're also, we want to have something like an upper node, father node, I don't know how to call it. It's going to be new. So, our father node equal to a node. Else, if previous depth is smaller than, can be smaller, should be smaller, yeah. Then father node left is gonna be equal to node. Else if previous depth is equal to depth, then father node right is gonna be equal to node. No, it's bad. We need a recursion of some kind. Otherwise, there are too many conditions and so on. Jesus, unfortunately, I do not have time to continue, but I want to solve this fucker. It's one of those problems where you can see that it's not very hard, but it's like you need just one little realization and it's gonna work. Let's say our current depth is 1. And our G node, well, it's obvious. Node new is oh, you solved it. That's cool. Well, in my LeetCoder career I solved 4 hard problems, but they are all hard problems from the first page. That's so cool. Let's say doesn't equal dash. Let's say for now we want to do that because we want to create our first node. It's gonna be S. And now we want again. To go here. think I did it, yeah. Oh no. Well, let's solve this one. It's not a very nice problem because, like, come on, three examples. But I solved something similar, you know. So for every root, okay, let's say an array is empty for now. And to this array, we want to add the root. Left, of course, if it I think I solved something similar. We want to create our array here, and we want to send it here. Also, we want to protect ourselves. We want to return if no root. I don't know. We never stopped. That's interesting. Or it's very deep. No, it's not even deep. Well, it's always easier to do this. Wait, pre-order traversal. I did something else. It's like 1, 2. So we go to the left. Most, then we go to the right. Yeah, I just forgot what it means. That's what I did. But we want to start, oh yeah, adding to the array. No, we want to start from 1. Then we go to the left. Oh, this is very strange. Okay, we add this 1. Like this it should be. Node, then left, then right. Something like this. But the problem, I think, was something else. Because we hit. Yeah, Stack Overflow. How could it happen? It's always easier to do this at first with just done if no root. Oh. Oh. Jesus, of course. That's better. We gave null, that's why. Well, let's just return this bastard if no root. Okay, we solved this one, I think. The strange thing is, oh no, it's right, they did the same thing. Strangely, when I first read this problem, I read it as BFS. Okay. Well, I understand how it works, just a lot harder with this string. I need to drink something. Let me take this tree and use it here as a test case. I want to see what kind of an output I'm gonna get. Let's reverse engineer this shit. Ah, beautiful. What are we gonna get? Okay, put this like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It doesn't help. What means, what does it mean, iterative, like with a while loop? Okay. Depth level. Yeah, I think I can do this, but it's very ugly. So let's say we have nodes. We have nodes. It's gonna be something like root. Let's say while they are not empty. Our node is gonna be Shift nodes. This is our node. Not sure what's gonna happen here. Oh, it's not nodes shifted. It's another way around. Why? Oh yeah. This one that I added doesn't work. It's a problem. But why? 157. So we are here, we add this to our nodes, we check it, we add one to our array. Our nodes are empty, we add this one and this one to our nodes. We take this one again, two, put it to our array. Instead of it, we add 3, 4, 5. Here we add 3. We go deeper, there's nothing. So we take 4. We add it, but there is nothing deeper. We go to 5, we add it. Now, instead of 5, we have 6 and 7. 6, 7, yeah. But it doesn't work like that. I don't know why. Let's check this out. So we take something. Strange. Nodes shift. Maybe I just do not know something about unshift, how it works, I don't know. Maybe it's not unshift, it's something else. Well, yeah, unshift. Maybe we need to do this, or do this with the exclamation mark, I don't know, let's see if it's gonna be any better. Nothing changed. Oh, I'm a moron. I'm a bloody fool. That was painful. That was painful. Great. Well, it's done recursively. Not recursively. How did you call it? Iteratively. It's done. How does it help us? Let's say we want to go from the end. I don't want to go from the end. Another way around. like we want to divide this string in two halves, but it's not very easy. Well, that was what I was trying to do here. I think we need a regular expression for this, maybe, I don't know. Let's say s split. Can we split by a regular expression? I hope so. And I want to split by dash, but I do not want it. Well, yeah. Because otherwise we can't break it in two halves without regex, because I won't use regex that would give me just one dash but not 2, 3, 4, or 5 dashes, you know. How do we do this? Let's go to, how is it called, the Rubular? I don't remember. Yes, it's a Rubular. Let's say my test string is like this, and I want, no, I want just one. Nope, oh, not A. Is let me see. Where is it? Here is it. Followed by any digit. And in our case it's not gonna happen. You're gonna have something like this, right? But it's not... I forgot my regex. Negative look ahead we need. See, it doesn't even have information here about look aheads. And we want negative. Good. But I want to be able to use my depth as a variable here. How do we? Use variable in regex in Ruby. Is it gonna work? I'm not sure. I do not believe that. It shouldn't work. Of course not. Oh, but it's not a regular expression anymore. Come on. I lost my regular expression. S? Oh, it's not S? Oh, it's traversal. It's a traversal. Definitely we need two halves. And we want to do the same for every string that we get. Nice. So we're gonna create a node, of course. I do not have any imagination today. Well, let's call it array, you know. So it's gonna be array 0 to y, For now, I want to create another method. It will be easier for me to do this. This second method. We want to let's call it helper. I'm too tired to be very imaginative. So it's a helper, and we send it a string. We're gonna do exactly the same thing with our string, of course. And of course we want depth. Depth. What are we gonna send? We're gonna send array 0. We're gonna say depth plus 1. And for the right node, what are we going to do here? The same thing, of course. The same thing. So yeah, now I'm gonna too long. Too big number. This is bullshit. It can't be too big. That's because we need to return in some cases. It's like if traversal is an empty line, maybe like this. So, is an empty line. Oh, wait a second. Not like this. No, why not like this? Let me think. So depth plus one, depth plus one. Depth two, three. We have a problem here. What happens when we split by some bullshit? Let's say we have an array one, not array, string A, B, C, D, and we're gonna split it by E. What we're gonna get? Just a full array, right? A full string, I mean, yeah. Okay. If traversal and what does match return, by the way? I'm not sure. One, no, two. I'm so close. Let's say we have something like this. No matches. But if we have two, we have a match. Looks good. Why does it break? Okay, we have a problem. Why is this now? Oh, of course. Not of course. Why is it now? Well, obviously we can have a problem here if we do not have anything here. So yeah, let's return if traversal, if no traversal, or why do we get null? Oh, it's obvious. Well, it's better, but we stopped. Why did we stop? Wait. No. Don't wait. I don't know. I'm too tired to be happy. But notice that I solved it with recursion also. Not iteratively. And it's a question how to solve it iteratively. I think it's a lot harder. Recursion usually is easier. Well, I will try to solve it your way, but probably tomorrow. Because I usually try to solve it both ways when it comes to trees, just to have a practice. Ooh. Great. It's our fifth hard problem. And now it's time to continue with my day. Jesus, it was a crime to devote this much time to this problem. Ah, it's time to run. Well, thank you, zombie killer whale, for being here. It's time to go.